Hello friends, I am Dr. Vijay Prakash and today I will be talking to you about illusions in fixed prosthodontics. Now what do you mean by illusion? Illusion is an act of changing perception to cause an object to appear different than that it is actually. So basically we are using optical concepts to create optical illusions. That is, you are changing the size and shape, that is, you are changing the contour, but at the same time, you are making that restoration or a tooth to appear different than it is actually. So, there are different fundamentals and principles which help to create illusion. One is the principle of illumination. Principle of illumination is the perception that the light approaches and the dark recedes. So basically this is the principle of illumination, and principle of light is that modification the amount of light that is deflected or reflected from the object will affect the sharpness of the perception which will be used to create the phenomena of illusion. Next is principle of line. It is basically the use of horizontal and vertical lines and ridges. So horizontal lines make the object appear more wider, whereas vertical lines make the object appear narrower than it is. Apart from this, you have the law of face. Now let us see what is law of face. Now what is face of the tooth? Face of the tooth is that area on the facial surface, both on the anterior and posterior teeth, that is bound by the transitional line angles as viewed from the facial or the labial or the buccal aspect, wherever the teeth is located. So this is basically these transitional line angles which are there on the surface of the teeth, which is the face of the tooth. And these transitional line angles which you see here, they basically mark the transition from the facial surface to the mesial side or the distal side or the cervical side or the incisal side. And the tooth surface slopes lingually in the mesial aspect and distal region. Like if you see this tooth, the tooth will slope mesially and distally. That is towards the lingual surface. From this aspect, it is going to slope towards the mesial aspect, that is towards the lingual side, and here also from this transition line angles, it is going to slope towards the distal surface. Whereas it is going to slope in the cervical region, it is going to slope towards the root surface like this. So you have the transitional line angles and it is going to slope towards the root surface in the cervical aspect. So the shadows which are created as the light strikes the facial surface of the tooth begin at the transitional line angles, and these shadows delineate the boundaries of the facial form. Thus, the apparent face is that portion of the face that is visible to the observer from any single view. Law of the face basically implies making dissimilar teeth similar by making the apparent faces equal, and the apparent faces should be manipulated, not the actual face, as we were talking about definition of illusion also. In that also we had talked about the same thing. Now let us see, what do we do to create illusion in a fixed restoration? Suppose this is your normal tooth, this central incisor, and I want to create an illusion which gives me a widened look. So this is the normal tooth, wherein you see there is light reflection and there is deflection of the light on the surface of the tooth. So how do we create a widened surface of the tooth? So creating illusion for widening, we have to displace the line angles laterally, as you can see, and flatten the facial outline. That is, you're going to just flatten the surface on the facial aspect, and you highlight the texture and gloss with the horizontal lines and ridge, and also reduce the facial embrasure. So this will help in making the truth appear more widened as it is actually. Now, what do we do to narrow the truth surface? If we want to narrow the restoration or a crown, then what we need to do is displace the line angles more mesially. That is, you make it more towards the midline of the tooth and increase the convexity of the facial outline. So you increase the contour of that and increase this convexity of this outline and highlight the texture with vertical lines and ridges and increase the facial embrasure. In widening, we were decreasing the facial embrasure, but here we have to increase the facial embrasure and the shadow and proximal aspects with aesthetic staining. If you give, then you make the restoration appear more narrower than it is actually. Next, what do we do to make the restoration appear more short? Now, here the emphasis is more on the prominence of the convexities. Like you have to make the surface, the facial surface, more convex, as you can see, so that the reflection of light is only in this particular area, the more of deflection. So this will make the restoration appear more short. Displace the cervical convexities coronally, as you have seen, as you can see in the figure. You highlight the texture and gloss with horizontal lines and ridges, and you emphasize the cemento enamel junction. So this is going to make all this, if you incorporate in the restoration, then you are going to shorten the restoration than it is actually. Now, what do you do in order to lengthen or increase the length of the restoration? First thing is you flatten and displace the cervical convexities. As you can see here, there is flattening of the cervical convexity, and you see the deflection of the light, it is straight. So when the observer is observing, it appears that the crown or the restoration is more longer than it is actually. And here you highlight the texture and gloss of the line angles and create vertical ridges, because if you're creating vertical ridges, you can increase the length, as I told you in the beginning. And also you lighten the cervical aspect. That will also help in basically lengthening the restoration than actually it is. So if you incorporate all these things, then you create an illusion in a restoration. Either you can widen that or shorten it or make it more longer or narrower. It depends how you are creating the contours of the restoration or the tooth. Another aspect of importance in illusion is depth. Now, depth is a special concept of color blending which combines the concepts of opacity and translucency. Like in a natural dentition, if we see that the light passes through the translucent enamel and is reflected from the depth of the relatively opaque dentine. So if you want to simulate this in an artificial restoration, then what you need to do, for example, natural illusion of a depth can be resulted if you apply more opaque, say if you're doing a composite restoration or doing a composite veneer, then you use a more opaque composite which you place it more lingually, and over that you overlay with basically translucent resin. So this will give an effect of depth, and this is going to give an illusion of a natural restoration. So this is all about illusion in fixed restoration. Thank you for watching the video.